It's a traffic stop gone bad. As one passenger from a car threatens a police officer, the other opens fire. But it's not real.
There is a laser at the end of the barrel here that will send, it'll send out a beam and impact on the screen.
At the final meeting of the 2011 Dalton Police Department Citizens Police Academy, citizens got an up-close look at the Firearms Training Simulator, or FATS, to learn how police officers practice for real-life situations.
It was a lot tougher than I was expecting. It's real different, even in the simulator. You know, you always think somebody's coming after you with a weapon, you're just going to shoot them, but that time passes real fast.
I have more respect. I mean, I already had some respect, but I mean, I learned that when someone goes to approach you, that you really don't have that much time. Like with the bottle, he got like, 2 feet from me?
The FATS machine projects a law enforcement scenario onto a screen. Users have simulated weapons and interact with actors on the screen. It's all controlled by an officer with a computer. Tonight, citizens got an idea of just how quickly a bad situation can get worse.
It's not a job that I envy. It takes a special person to be able to do that on a daily basis.
So at this point, we need to treat him as a burglary suspect.
It isn't real, but after this final class in the 10-week, 30-hour Citizens Police Academy, participants have a much better idea how Dalton officers handle the real thing.
We've learned a lot about what they do on a daily basis, things that you just wouldn't think about. I think the biggest thing is that it's put a human face on the police department. It's not just the popo or somebody going to try to get you a ticket for going 5 miles an hour over the speed limit. They do a much bigger job.
To learn more about the Citizens Police Academy, visit the Dalton Police blog at daltonpdblog.org. For the Dalton Police Department, I'm Chris Frazier.